Let's say you're having coffee with a friend and bring up how you need a new fan for the summer. Then bam, all of a sudden there are ads everywhere for fans. This is not some hypothetical situation. Is my phone spying on me? Certain apps do indeed have access to your microphone because you gave them this access. But that doesn't mean they're constantly looking for words they can send out to Google or some other advertising network to immediately send us target ads. Because they don't have to do that. There are so many ways they can check where we're going, what we like, and what we're thinking. If you have Hey Siri set up on your iPhone,
Hey Siri!
The smart speaker is always active and monitoring voices to your trigger words, and from that point, your data can be sold. The truth is, everything we do is being tracked. When you add something to your cart, that's tracked. If you buy cat food every 2 weeks, don't be surprised if 2 weeks go by and start seeing cat food ads. Meta has created a device called Pixel, which is a way to continue tracking you online, even after you left the website using cookies.
I can't keep giving him cookies!
They don't have to listen to your conversations, because they already have your search history, in-app interactions, past purchases, online profiles, and favorite websites. And they share your information with advertisers for a price. These companies will claim they aren't doing anything you haven't agreed to, as you have accepted the privacy policy that allows the collection of your information. And did you read the fine print? Just kidding, no one reads that. But one of the scarier parts is the accelerometer data. It's basically one of the only features on your phone that doesn't have to ask permission to send the data wherever the heck you want to. Let's say you're riding the bus and you have turned off all the privacy features on your phone. But friend 2 here also has an iPhone but hasn't optimized it. So even when you're not actively using your phone, this doesn't mean your device is not taking in and recording the information around you. This means your phone may start sending you ads for swimsuits just because you were physically near a surf shop or your friend just casually searched for them. And we're not even talking about AI. Although it may sound bad, we use social platforms for free. With the caveat that these companies will then collect their data and share with external parties for profit. And should we care about online privacy anyway? It helps businesses reach new audiences. It makes the ads you inevitably see better match your interests. Spending money on the stuff is required sometimes, and it powers personalized experiences online. Thanks to data collection, YouTube learned to show us videos of the things you like. But indeed, these brands and websites sell and share everything about you with advertisers, politicians, and even law enforcement. Weirdly, people don't really get the option to say no to all this data sharing. So, should you be concerned? Generally, no, but how much you care about privacy depends on how all of this makes you feel. If you like personalized online experiences and gathering information about yourself isn't a priority, then maybe this isn't such a bad thing. But if you're uncomfortable with your data being collected, there are a few ways to stop your phone from listening. The explanations and links are in the description. Long story short, your phone is capable of listening to you, following you, and even watching you. But maybe that's not so worrying after all. It depends on how much you care.